To make some frequency generator, I found this schematic on the internet. It uses an Arduino Nano and two modules and a rotary encoder, and they could all be purchased very cheap. And it has even a signal strength meter on it and some switches. One of the switches can be used from the rotary encoder, and the TX switch is of course in the transmitter. And I ordered these parts, and it looks like a nice project to make in a few hours. These are the parts that I ordered. Arduino Nano for the value of €2.67. And here the breakout board with Si5351 on it. The rotary encoder, also on a small PCB. And of course the very small OLED display. And this has the value of €5.13. For under €10, you have a very nice project. When you have a closer look to the schematic, you see that the I2C signal is to several modules, so in fact you can make loops in it. So I did two wires at the same point, in this case A5, and I solder it. Like this, and now the rest of the wiring the same way. A minute or so later and the wiring is soldered, the double wiring, two for the I square C and two for the plus 5 volt and ground. So I just have to cut off the extensive lid. And that's it. Then I have to do some wiring that goes to the switches, the rotary switch and the other switches. And that's it. That's all the wiring. Some of the wires I made double, especially for the ground I added wires. And one hole was not completely open, so it was a bit difficult to get the wire in it. But this all won't take a very long time. Now I add the other units on it. I purchased this rotary switch, and it is not in accordance with the schematic. It has two switch inputs, and I want to use one of those buttons as for the switch here, so not the rotary. But in fact the PCB here says ground, S1, S2, key and 5 volt. And I checked it, and when I have the key and the ground, then I have shortened it by switching it. And the others are the keys, so I don't use the 5 volt. That's what I'm going to try. And the rotary switch is soldered. And the SI5351 module is soldered to the four wires. Not too complicated, but the challenge was the wires are so short, how to get the isolation of it properly. And the four remaining wires are soldered to the display unit, very small display unit. And the remaining wires are for ground, the switches and the S-meter input. And I soldered the switch. I knew that I had it somewhere, but I found it. That take maybe the most time of the whole project, searching for the switch. Looking to the sketch, I remember I had first to install these libraries, and then I can upload the sketch to the Arduino. In the sketch, the location of the libraries is mentioned. However, when I went to such a website, I couldn't find it. The solution was easy. You can search a long time, but there's a button here, and when you push in it, you can find the download zip, and you place it in the folder that you have your sketch in, and then you can use it. Just simple like that. And when I uploaded the sketch, I saw this as a result, very nice display. And when I have the rotary encoder, you can do the step size, and with this button you can change the bend, like you can see. And when I change the step size, for example, to 1 megahertz, then when turning, you should see, of course, steps of 1 megahertz, but that's not the case in this case. Strange enough, some things I think I have to do something with the 5 volt on the PCB, because this rotary encoder is different than is mentioned in the schematic. I now added the 5 volt line to this rotary encoder. It seems that there are pull-up resistors on the PCB, and by adding the 5 volt, it now functions normal. I have now the 5 kilohertz steps standard. When I push it, when I push this rotary encoder button, it will go to 1 megahertz now, and when I turn it, you see that it increase, it decrease with 1 megahertz. And that's the wrong direction. Now I exchanged the 2 wires on the rotary encoder, and you can see that the direction is now okay, 101, and counterclockwise 99. And now the proof of the pudding. I put the frequency to 145 megahertz. I put a small wire on the output, the clock 0, and when I switch on my 2 meter transceiver on this frequency, you hear nothing, logically, because it has an IF of 455 kilohertz here. But when I push the TX wire to ground, it says IF OK, so no IF, then you see that you hear the tone. And when you turn the rotary encoder, you see that it is changing frequency. And this is the LED display. I have to connect that to something. So that's it for now. This project will of course have a follow-up. When you subscribe, then you will be informed when it happens. Watch out for short circuits. See you!